Hi dear friends, and this is my video presentation for a disco conference which is going on now in Prague 26th-27th of June. Disco conference 2017, open education, a way to knowledge society. Let's go!
Yes, I see you and I hear you. Okay. So the topic of this video presentation, enhancing professional awareness of print service translators via the project work. This is the case study. And well, actually, in the very beginning, it was not supposed to be a research. It was just an attempt to make the teaching and make the learning more beneficial for the students. But then, in the course of the work, in the course of the, our collaboration with the students, we came up to certain results, and I'd like to share with you. So, in this presentation, I'm going to speak about the methodological problems of training translators. Also, I will talk about the aims and methods of this study, the content and stages of the project work itself, and the results. Results through observations and through the students' feedback. And after all, some conclusions about the benefits of project work in the program of training students, and also some enhancements, how to make it more beneficial, and some insights about ICT tools and technologies in the context of this work. For a start, I'd like to speak about the methodological problems of designing the program for training translators. In fact, we have to mention that translation as a science is still very young in comparison to others, because it just was separated from linguistics in 1950s. And so it is really a very much interdisciplinary science, which is based on the achievements of linguistics, of literature, of social sciences, and very many other fields. So that's why there are very many disputes about the subject of translation, the methods of translation. And up to perhaps 10 years before, and in the previous practices, translators were trained just in intensive courses and workshops to start their work. So the university programs for training translators are comparatively new. So that's why there are very many discussions and disputes. What should be put into the program of training translators? What skills and competences they should develop within the, their training programs? Where and what we as instructors should focus to make our students more professional and more adaptable for the needs of the professional world of translation. So that's why here we are having kind of dilemmas like translation, what is it? It is a science or a craft? Is it a science or interdisciplinary knowledge? So should we make a focus on theoretical knowledge or provide more practice and develop practical skills? And by the end, what should be within the content of the training programs? So what we are having now? First of all, we should mention, and these are the difficulties and hardships of training translators, that during their first years of study, they already have to deal with the theoretical courses. And they are expected to analyze the language and to understand deep structures of their mother tongue and the foreign language. They have to realize and to get the meaning of the hidden meanings to be able to convey this meaning in the translation properly. Well, and of course, they are expected to perform properly and appropriately using their foreign language which they are learning. And together with that, on the top of that, they have to be aware of societal, cultural, historical, and very many other factors which affect translation. But what we are having on the part of the students. So when they are coming to their first year of the study in the program, very many of them are unfortunately still need some more practice in the general competence of foreign language. They are having, unfortunately, limited language knowledge, limited linguistic knowledge and skills of analyzing and understanding the language. And of course, they still have lots of hardships to follow theories and to understand terminologies which are used to operate, to speak about different abstract notions within the theoretical courses. To cope with these discrepancies, to meet these difficulties, or maybe to breach the requirements and the reality, we have to enhance the quality of learning. We have to search for alternative methods and techniques to enhance the quality and to facilitate the learning, and also to make traditional learning more effective for our students. What do I mean by alternative methods? Well, so alternative methods in these presentations are those which are entitled to enhance student-centeredness. Well, the notion of student-centeredness, in fact, is not new in the paradigm of educational theories and practice, but still in reality of teaching and the reality of learning, the traditional methods continue to prevail. Well, and alternative methods are those which would provide collaboration and the construction of knowledge through social interaction. Well, considering the methodological problems of training translators and considering these discrepancies between the requirements and the real abilities of our students, the aim of this study was to enhance the quality of training pre-service translators via implementation of the project work. What is really very much important and crucial for the modern project work? That is the ability to provide enhancements through technologies. So, what are these enhancements? First of all, it is the possibility for providing and for conducting real research in interaction with different communities. It is the possibility to reach distant partners and communities and collaboration. It is a chance to communicate and to record this communication for further analysis. It is an opportunity to contact with the experts, which is out of the classroom. It is also a good chance to test hypotheses and ideas and to get feedbacks for the evaluations. And of course, once again, what is more important, to step out of the classroom limits, to get experience and to apply the theoretical knowledge which we are gaining in theoretical courses in real life, in real practice. Well, so supplementary purposes of this study was to test implementation of the project work in the context of the translators training programs, to test social media tools in the context of the project work, and to identify ICT tools applied by the students in case of solving professional tasks. Topics of the projects were entitled to be closely connected with the content of the course. And in the very beginning, I talked about that too. The insights on the topics and the overview of their problems and the different issues under the discussion were introduced to give the students the idea about the content, about the problems which are under discussion. So within the course for introduction to translation, to the course which is which became the base for one group of students to prepare their project work, we had in the content such topics as external knowledge about translation, internal knowledge or how the users of translation view translation as activity, translator as a learner and process of translation, experience and in translation and people, translation and terminology, language study and translation, social networks, tools and resources in translator's profession, and importance of analysis in translation. So according to this content, the students define their own topics and their own interests.
We are going to present our plans and what we are going to do in our project. Our subject is experiences of translators, experiences of technical and mechanical translation.
So these projects were according to those topics which they stated. Translator as a learner, specifics of technical translation, how to become a better translator and interpreter, professional insights, and insights into the simultaneous translation, how to deal with the technical terms in translation, social media in translation, professional experience.
So our topic is process of learning and process of becoming a translator. And our aim is benefiting from their experiences, how their learning styles affected their professional areas, and how did they come to where they are now, how did they develop their language skills, and these kind of things.
As a learner, and we narrowed it down to study technical terms. We will talk about in this presentation how it is hard to, even for a translator, to learn technical terms, because languages are evolving and every day there are new technical terms coming. So a translator to translate everything has to learn every day.
Well, and another course which was in the base of the project work was the course on linguistics, and the content of this course included such topics as the classification of languages, history of language, first language acquisition, second language acquisition, psycholinguistics, neurolinguistics, social linguistics, natural sign language, writing and language, and computational linguistics. So according to the topics, the issues which concerned social linguistics and language acquisition arose most of interest among our students.
Yes,
thank you.
Yes.
Okay.
So our presentation was about children and their how their stages of learning a new language.
Okay.
Our topic is not even it's not about that actually. Like, you just wanted to, it's a tiny detail in our subject, because our subject is much more wider, and we are here to talk about the kids learning a language, their first mother tongue. So that's a tiny little detail in there. What is the differentiation between girls and boys? I don't even think that it's about our subject.
After all brainstormings and defining the teams and discussing the initial ideas in the teams, the students were supposed to present their project proposal. And the project proposal had to follow the following scheme. First of all, the subject of the research, its connection with the topic of the course, reasons to choose the topic of the study or topicality, the team members, methods of the research, instruments like survey or interview, equipment used, ICT tools, video camera, whatever, which they were planning to apply to get data or maybe to analyze the situations, target audience, who is intended to be interacted with, procedures, deadlines, how responsibilities are shared in the group, and anticipated outcomes of the projects. Outcomes of the projects were supposed to be like obtain knowledge, skills, possible impact of the project on the other learners, communities, the whole course, and so on and so forth.
Everyone, today we are going to talk about our proposal of the project. Our topic is experience. Our topic is how to gain experience and how to become a better translator and interpreter.
Okay.
Participants, experienced and expert translators that we are going to interview, at least 10 of them. For example, Sanjay Joshi is a subtitle translator who is translating.
For now, we have a subtitle translator, but we can arrange interviews in medical or law translators. We are going to use subtitle workshop for any subtitles, the records we are taking. Then we can for Skype recordings, Skype for interviews, Camtasia and Sony Vegas Pro for video editing, and smartphones for face-to-face recording.
We are going to interview on Skype, and we are going to make it in Turkish or English and different translators.
We are going to add, if it's Turkish, we are going to edit subtitle in English. If it's English, we are going to add Turkish subtitles. We translate it.
Our topic was about the quality of the second language teaching in Turkey, in Turkish schools. And we wanted to ask some students who had education in Turkey to see if they are satisfied, if they see the quality of the education well enough.
The greatest achievement, I guess, within the project was the organizing and holding the conference. And it was the first students' conference. And what was really very much valuable about that they were organizing the conference by themselves. And the same situation that everything was initiated within the group, within the class, and then with the further discussion, further collaboration, and coming up already to the whole event. So the stages there involved developing the idea and framework of the conference, group discussion of the conference logo, agreeing on its content and design, implementation, developing the conference program and poster, leading the conference, holding the conference, speaking at the conference and participating in the follow-up discussions, and providing summary translations to the presentations. Well, now we are coming up to the results. And results, of course, the results of the project, and as I mentioned, the greatest achievement was the conference itself, and it was held in the hall, and was organized according to all requirements of the academic events. Well, now about observations. Observations about the students' performance before the project work, during the project work, and after it. And how the project work affected their whole performance in the class. First of all, it should be mentioned that students didn't have any prior experience of any projects before, and it was a new technique, a new activity for them. So that's why it's on the one hand it rose lots of interest and enthusiasm, and but on the other hand, lots of stress and even panic. Together with that, this interest and excitement brought their increasing participation in the class and high involvement in the classroom discussions. It was also noticed that the students who used to be in the used to be passive a bit in the class and preferring to sit silently, they became more involved and had to speak in front of the class and to perform. Another benefit that the students got the insights of the content of the course before the actual lectures, and also when they were reporting on different topics of their projects, we were dealing in fact with different situations concerning the theoretical content of the topic. So that's why they got a more ample understanding of the content before or prior to the actual lectures. When those lectures were coming, it was possible to already to connect the theoretical assumptions within the course and within the topic with their experience which they gained through the project work. Well, how it affected the performance and learning rate? It should be mentioned that the level of rates in final testing is significantly increased. But it should be mentioned too that students who used to fail, unfortunately they failed too, and should be mentioned that they were also trying to join the project work, and they were trying to do something, but then they gave up on performing their duties and left the group. So it was really very much pitiful for the whole context of our group work. Well, now we are coming to the data which were obtained through survey, and first of all, about the number of the students in the group, and most common it was that three people were within the group,
And about the sharing responsibilities and the tendencies of sharing responsibilities, most of them indicated that they shared responsibilities according to their abilities. Some of them also mentioned that they shared responsibilities before starting to work at the project. And but there were also those who didn't share any responsibilities, and it happened spontaneously. And after that, they shared them according to the skills and abilities of the team members. Well, as for the equal contribution to the project, so most of the students stated that each member contributed equally to the success of the project research. It's like about 68%, but still quite a big deal of those who mentioned that the contribution of each member was not equal, and those students are about 32%. So, what our students liked about the project work the most? And according to their feedbacks, the most exciting and most beneficial for them was to prepare the research and to present their results in front of other people at the conference. Also, they liked interviewing professional translators and meeting different people who are working in the area of translation. Well, they liked the experience during the conference that they mentioned, also they learned different points of view at translation while interacting with the different communities. Some of them indicated that the best part of the project was that they became feeling more confident about themselves, and this experience helped to enhance and to develop their academic skills. Well, some of them indicated we gained experience not only about translation, but also about ICT tools like Sony Vegas and others. Another comment, even though I was sleepless many nights because of it, I've learned how to use Sony Vegas and I'm still keeping on using these programs. Well, as for trouble things and those which made our students more stressful about the project and its duration. Well, the hardest part was to find translators or respondents for the project research. Well, then the problem was about the necessity to make changes in the presentation when it was already finalized. A challenge was to prepare a speech and to speak in front of people at the conference, arranging free time to meet the partner and to collaborate and to work together. And also the trouble thing was some lacking of information, what to do and how to perform within the project. Well, advantages. Advantages mentioned. First of all, getting in contact with the translators, presenting, learning about translation, doing mini-series, translating interviews, effective interaction and increasing motivation, bringing us together and having good time together, improving communication with people, gaining experience and knowledge about the market, making translations, experiencing standing at the stage and speaking in front of people, improving speaking skills, improving self-esteem, learning what to do after the graduation, gaining experience on ICT tools, and so on and so forth. Well, disadvantages. Still, together with the excitement from the interacting with the translators and experts from out of the classroom, that was the most stressful part, and very many students were sharing their trouble moments about that issue. So about that disadvantage, that getting into contact with the translators was the hardest part. And they found themselves inexperienced for presentation, and it was also a kind of disadvantage which needed to be coped with and maybe to give more time for training and rehearsals before the conference. Some indicated that there were no disadvantages at all, and some other responses were about that the project takes too long time and effort, it's very much stressful, and there were some limited topics and limited time on a realization of the project.
So, what our students would suggest to improve their work within the project? First of all, they say that maybe we as students will be better at presenting, and students need more experience and practice to perform well. Before starting project, the teacher should give the students all the important points about the project and its purposes. We should announce better about the conference to let more people know about the event and let them benefit from it. Maybe next time students work at their projects for a longer period of time, not during for one term, but for two terms, for example. To inform the participants to make their work better, to apply for receiving some funds for such project work.
We are out now, the job is done, over. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope to see you again with your subscriptions, this channel for a new educational video, and hope to see your comments to make it even better. Thank you very much. Have a good time. Bye-bye.